Welcome back, lovelies, to Let's Play Residence Evil 1. I don't know why I said it like that. With me, XelionGraves. Now, let's make sure everything's working. Just to be on the safe side. I don't know why I said it. Okay. Timer back up. Skype back up. I still haven't figured out how to get my timer to permanently be on the screen. Anyway, moving on. Where's the door? There we go. So, we are in a residence. Thank you, truck. I don't remember how we got here, but I'm sure it'll come back to me. Now, this door is locked, yes? Yes. Oh, the door plate reads 001. 001. The very first agent. Probably not. Excuse me. That's a thing. I told you I'm allergic to streaming. Anyway. Whoa! Tentacle monster! Oh my god! What the hell? So that's a thing? Okay. I guess we're going this way then, you pile of crap. Can I push? I can hop. I don't want to hop. Let's investigate this door. This mysterious, evil door. Which contains... moths! Ah! Anyway. What do we got here? There doesn't seem to be anything useful. There's a hair on my tongue. Blech. Hang on. Ah, got it. Man, that was really in there. Probably because I like to sleep on my face and all my hair just goes, it's still there. I don't know if I got it or not. I'm sure it's going to come back to haunt me. Anyway, doesn't seem to be anything useful. I mean, there's a couple statues there and a line of pictures. Surely it's something. More pictures that apparently we don't care about. And a window! Okay, then. Newspapers lie scattered about. They all contain articles about stars. That's us. Like, we're a member of Star's Bra... Alpha Team. Not Bravo Team. That's, Resident Evil Zero. It's locked. The door plate reads, Gallery. Well, at least they label things. I mean, that's nice. Can I read that thing on the wall? Nope, not important. This flashing thing is, though. Was ist das? Ooh, a map? Map of the Residence Evil. Take it? No, we can find our own way around. Yes, take the map. Okay, so we are here. And it shows that there's still something here. Interesting. Let's have another look around, Z. You got the map of the residence. There's a hole in the wall here. Oh. Well, look through the... You see a giant beehive? Oh, no. Oh. Go. Get out of here. I ain't messing with bees. No. It had to be bees, didn't it? Plant 42 report. 4 days have passed since the accident. The plant at point 42 is growing at an amazing rate. Although there are many unknown aspects about this plant, we do know that in comparison with the other group of plants, the T virus has a substantially stronger effect on this one. Is this the first reference to the T virus here, or... I'm not sure if we found anything prior to this about it, but yeah. The T virus has drastically morphed its host anatomy as well as its size. Looking at its current state, it's difficult to imagine the original appearance. Nowhere on Earth will you find anything like it. But on Mars, maybe even Venus, oh, our Interplanetary Umbrella Corporation technology... No. We've also found that Plant 42 has two main sources of acquiring its necessary nutrients. One source is through the root. Somehow, it has rooted itself down into the basement. Immediately after the accident, a scientist went mad and destroyed the aqua ring. Sounds like part of a puzzle. Ever since, the basement has been like a pool. There is... Oh, God, is it like the chest in Sea of Thieves that cries and floods your ship? Oh, dear. There is a high possibility that it's one of the chemicals in the plant that's... One of the chemicals in the water that's promoting the Plant 42's rapid growth. Aha. Could be. Maybe it got a sample of herbicide in the water and it was just like, you think that can stop me? Anyway. However, we have yet to determine the specific chemical. A bulb-like body of the Plant 42 has been sighted hanging from the ceiling of the first floor. We are sure that it used the air ducts to reach the first floor. It's a plant. It really doesn't need, like, a direct line to get where it needs to go. It can... You've seen the plants that, like, grow straight up through concrete? Plants don't give a crap! Anyway, numerous long, tentacle-like vines are protruding from the bulb. Oh! That's what grabbed me! Oh, dear. That means it's the rape tree from Evil Dead. Oh, boy, oh, boy. How fun our journey's gonna be. Anyway, we believe the vines... I didn't read all that. Yeah. We believe the vines in the second... Are... Bleh. We believe the vines are the second means of acquiring its nutrients. When the Plant 42 senses prey, it uses the tentacle-like vines to capture its prey. After doing so, suckers on the vines drain the prey of its blood. Ah, it's a blood drinker! Awesome. Always good. We've also noticed that it has some intelligence. When it captures its prey, or when it's inactive, the vines twine around the door to stop possible intruders. Unfortunately, several of our scientists have already fallen victim to this Plant 42. Goodness, my throat is... I am not ready to stream yet. Give me a sec. Should have ad-libbed some Castlevania or something at the start of this to warm up my throat. That's what I do whenever I get ready to stream. I just hum songs from various games that I know. Most of them, a lot of times, are at the very start of the video. Just cut off because that's when everything starts. It's weird, because, like, I start my timer with 20 seconds extra at the beginning, because it seems like it takes forever from when I hit stream to when it starts streaming. But, anyway, that's neither here nor there. When we heard the stories from the survivors, they all observed one thing in common. When the uniform petal-like flaps open and reveal its vital internals, it has a tendency to become more aggressive. Well, obviously, it's revealing its weak point. One witness reported that it was as if it was trying to protect itself. Why it behaves the way it does is still unknown. Well, it's... The survival instinct is one of the strongest in the entire animal kingdom. And plant kingdom. You know, there's plants that are like... carnivorous and secrete like poisonous enzymes and whatnot. If you touch it, you'll like numb your hand at best and kill off the nerves at worst. Sheesh. Anyway. And these guys call themselves scientists. May 21st, 1998, Henry Sartum. Okay, so that was a vast amount of knowledge about an enemy that we've yet to face, but we're probably going to, because that's why it gave us so much information about that enemy that we haven't faced. What? Heidi-ho! And bye to you! Don't do that to me! Also, Mr. French Horn, you can pack up and leave, too. Ugh. That was surprising, to say the least. There's nothing special. Wait a sec, what? We can push this bookcase. And also, nothing special. I see that cowboy hat over there. You can't fool me. Alright, let's go over this side. Yeah, this looks better. Oh, excuse me. What's that? Oh, there's a ladder! Climb down? Hang on. Wait. If we head back at... Wait, what? There's a door there! Oh, good thing I checked the map. Okay, so back in the room with the tentacle arm that grabbed our foot, we can go over that box and get into that room that leads to a bunch of... Well, looks like a stairwell. I don't like changing floors when exploring the map, so let's see here. Right here? Yaha! There we go. So we'll drop down the ladder in a bit. What is that sound? Really can't do anything with that. Water is leaking from the tank. Will you take the residence key? Ooh, yes I will. Please and thank you. Let's get a closer look on this thing. Aha! 101! That means we can open up the door that was marked 101, which is, I think, that red one right at the start on the left side. Awesome! So we can double back and get that, but first, I'd like to... Ah, blast it, I can't change floor of the map. Water drips from the sink. Perhaps the valve is broken. Why is everything so mysterious in here? I mean, I love the music. It's like, got this almost Twilight Zone air of mystery, but this is just a bathroom. There's nothing else there. Dogs out there barking away. My own dog's probably gonna start barking her head off too. She's asleep right now. I don't want to say her name and wake her up. Alright, let's climb down. Don't break. Please don't break. Do not break, ladder. Oh, thank goodness. I love the music in these places. It's so ephemeral, and it just gives this air of uncertainty all around, but with a distinct fascination with it. I like it. Also, just realized we're in the basement, which is what that place said was where the thing was, so, okay, I can move that. I can move all of these. Let's take the door first. It's locked. Why would there be so many boxes? It's a weird-looking hallway, too. Ah, that's what we'd need them for. Okay, so... That's pretty obvious. It looked about 3 blocks wide. Or, not wide, long. Maybe only 2. So then we'll grab this one and just push it on top of the other box, which logically would not work, but it seems like it should in this particular instance. Thank you, game logic! Oh! They actually accounted for that. Didn't see that one coming. Wait, I can't... Ah. I bet you it's just enough so that this box will push the others, get everything in alignment, and have just enough room to fit in between them. Hehe. Cool. Honestly, what I was expecting is being able to push the blocks on top of the other crates and just, like, push it to the edge and then it falls into the water. Having it knock him ahead, that's a pretty cool attention to detail. I like that. Ha! That went inside the other blocks and should not have bounced that much, but whatever. Okay. Cool. Awesome. And an herb! Which I am going to take with me, because, we got room. Uh-oh. Well, that's not good. Yeah, the door's still open, though. Thankfully, they got those gates on the bottom that can, like, move through. Oh, no! I saw this room in the sizzle reel whenever the game starts. Oh. Now I'm very worried about what's in this water. Wait, is there any- Oh, crap. Oh, they're here already, aren't they? Yeah! I'm not messing with Zombo Sharks! No! Oh, good lord. Don't just stand there, you silly! Alright, this looks important. Here we go. It's locked. The words Power Room are written on the door. Ah! There's a thingy over here. Yeah. Go away! Go! Yeah. Fear the shoddy! How many bullets do I have? 5. Not worth wasting on these guys. He's like hovering around where I need to be, isn't he? Nope, he went by. Fantastic! Alright, that's not so bad. Oh, come on! Yeah! I can't even see for a good angle if I'm shooting it or not. Ah! I'd say... No. No, that's not gonna work. Okay. Let us away. Okie dokie, let me just squeeze by you then. Yeah. Go away, Sharky dude! Ah! Oh goodness, there's another one. Yeah. I see you making a beeline for me. Go away! Good thing I picked up that herb. Ah, oh, sharks. There's two things that I do know are in this game. What, that heal me at all? Well, I guess I'm not clutching my side, so I must be fine. Ah! Whenever a scratch and itch and turned around. But yeah, two things that I know are in this game. One, those zombie sharks. Two, is a giant crocodile. Which... can't remember if it's in this game or the second game. It may actually be the second one. Because we've already had a giant snake. S- mysterious music in this room, too. Man, I gotta get the soundtrack to this game. The music here is better than I've heard in any Resident Evil game. Oh god, the bees! Not the bees! Not the bees! Okay. Let's see. That was gallery. So, yeah, I just need to head back. Go away, giant insects! I don't have enough bullets for any of you. I have to imagine they take at the very least, one shot each for... What the hell are we doing way up here? Wait, what? Huh? Doesn't make any sense. Why can I climb up there if I can't do anything with it? Can I push this? No. That's weird. Oh well. Ah, yeah, I was watching the other hole! Get off of me! Yeah. Curse you! So that's a thing. Where's the... It is here. Okay, I'm gonna go in here and get a first aid herbal remedy. Ah. Me heart! Anyway. So, let's go ahead and get this. Thankfully, the door we need is right over there. So, let's get a mixed herb. Actually, no. We have a ton of first aid sprays. Let's just use one of those. Or wait, no. We're at a pretty good spot, right? No, we're not. Okay. We'll put that back in the box and just use one of these. Yeah. I mean, all things considered, same difference, but eh. I like using my mixed herbs more than the pre-made first aids. And I'm not gonna use the blue herb for cure poison. Pfft. Screw that. I'm not going to mix it in with the other stuff. If it comes to it, I'll just use it on its own. Also, this. There is a door. It's also a box. I'm gonna try to set this box over the hole that the tentacle keeps coming out of. See if that gives me an easier way to get over there. There. So now I can just climb over the box. Awesome. Fantastic. Oh my god, come on, you piece of... Ugh. Oh, I hate you. I hate you, tentacle arm thing of doom. Oh. Gah. Okay. We use the key. No need for the key, let's discard it. But, before we go in there... Or actually, no, that's a smaller area. Yeah, let's go here. Then I'm going to check out the other doors. Oh, the tentacle! Every time I think I'm done with it... What is that? Oh! Okay. Hi. Are you alive? Well, I can't aim at you, so I guess not. Okay, hang on. Before any of that... Is this another bathroom? How swanky is this place? I can't aim at that body on the ground, but I don't trust it. It's full of dirty water. Pull out the plug? No. Let me get over here. I just know that as soon as I pull this plug, that body over there is gonna get up and try to kill me. Watching you. There's something inside the bathtub. What the hell is that? That is a big key. Hang on a sec. If that's just a key, that thing is... It's bigger than my fist! Oh my god! Okay, we'll take the giganto control room key. Get a good look at this, too. It's a key for entering the control room. Huh, you don't say, huh? It's a cool-looking key, I'll give it that. Alright. Now you get up. Stay down. Alright. Anything in the toilet? No. A well-polished mirror. Given the state of the rest of the area, that is strange. Alright, how many... Oh, I have 2 shots left. That sucks! Get out of here! Where are all the bullets? Yeesh. I literally have 3 bullets left and that's it. I hate that I can't look over that guy. This bed shows signs of having been used. Ooh, a thingy! Self-defense gun? What? Suicide note. June 22nd, 1998. I had to do it. We ran from those things, helping each other to survive. But Robert started showing the symptoms. I had to do it. Those damned things are pure evil. There's no other way. He would have done the same if it were the other way around. After I put him out of his misery, I just had to leave him in the bathroom. Now I'm probably the last one. How could this happen? I'll never forgive myself for being part of this project. Eventually, I'll get what's coming to me, though. There's no way to escape from this nut house. It's just a matter of time now. Everything is set. All I need is a little courage to get it done. Knowing that I'll leave many things undone is regret beyond words. But this is better than just waiting to turn into one of them. Please understand, then at least let me end my life as a person. There's a message on the back. Linda, please forgive me. Linda, I don't want to die. So, Dudo in the bathroom was obviously... stole the phone! Handgun bullets! Sweet! How do I... circle. Wait a minute. More bullets! Ah! Oh, you lovely, wonderful person, you! Okay, now... What is this? A self-defense gun that fires 22 magnum rounds. One round has already been fired. What's that say? Of course! It's a Dillinger! You don't see many of those. Mostly because they're incredibly tiny and very awkward, yet... somehow... kinda nifty. Okay, so, we've got a one-shot Magnum. A very small caliber Magnum, but still a Magnum. An old bookcase. The books are mostly concerned with literature and philosophy. Delightful. But yeah, dude in the bathroom was Robert, I think? And this one is the one who wrote the note. Mind you, eventually that rope's gonna snap, and... that one's gonna attack me, probably. I mean, strangulation, hanging, you're cutting off all circulation to the brain, so it starts to atrophy and die. No. No, because a bullet doesn't just kill brain cells, it removes them. The T-virus reanimates dead flesh, so the brain's still in there. So it's got all the pieces needed. It would probably still be able to reanimate that. I get it, bye! Nope! Nope! Right out of there! Nope, 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 nope! First thing I'm doing, lightening my load. Oh, why did it have to be spiders? Okay. Now, let's see how much time I got. Oh, I still got nearly 10 minutes. Okay, so, let's put this bad... I have half a mind to actually use this on the spider, but no. We need to put this away. Just like so. And... Now we'll keep... I'll let you in a minute, okay, buddy? Let's see... I don't think we'll need the crank for a while, so let's put that... Yeah, we'll put that there. Replace it with the first aid, because I just know I'm going to need it. Alright. So, we're going to use a shotgun on the spider, because that's how you squish bugs. Oh my goodness. He's just going to claw on the door until I let him in. I'll let you in after the episode. Alright, so, it's right above me as soon as I get in here. What? There he is! Crap! Ha! The fastest gun in the evil! Ah. Red oil lamp. It's not lit. Wait, don't I have a thing? Don't I have... Yeah, a lighter. A strange silhouette hovers in the reddish light. Ooh, an eye! Could it have some kind of meaning? Oh, God, the thing... Ugh! It's squelching! Stop that! Ugh. Rack of wine bottles. They're all cheap vintages. Hey, sometimes the cheap wine is the good wine. Price set for most of these is an artificial thing. Anyway, rack full of wine bottles. I already read that. Okay, so this... Oh, now you... Oh, come on. I fed you before we started, you silly. Okay, so... let me have a look-see. There's no other doors here. As much as that looks like a door. No painting that apparently we can't care about. Ooh, a leather jacket. Part of it's been burned by acid. Probably spider acid. Oh! I can aim at something. I don't see anything from here, but it's good to know that Chris Redfield knows something's up. This partition is decorated with dishes. Oh my God, I see it now. Ha! Ugh. Seems to just be staying there. Nope, I saw that. Are you coming up the stairs? Better question, can I shoot him from here? Ha! Yes! Wow! It took barely any time at all! Maybe these spiders are weaker than I thought. An advertise- Oh my God, hang on.
Oh, goodness, you too? Ow! You landed on my foot.
Alright. Outside, outside, inside, outside.
Columbus! Hey buddy.
Okay.
Oh, y'all need feeding again? Alright. Give me a sack. Oh my god, guys! I'm in the process of feeding you! You silly. There you go.
And let me guess. Logan! Yep.
Okie dokie. One last one for you. There you go.
Logan thinks that going outside means he gets food inside, even if he's only outside for, like, literally 2 seconds. Anyway, let's see, 4 minutes. An advertisement for an arm wrestling contest. The winner will be named Chief for a Day of the Raccoon Police Department. Why would that be here? We're not at the RPD. The RPD isn't even in this place, is it? Oh, good lord, what the hell? Oh, great! Quit inching toward me! Alright. I think I'll just try my darndest to navigate around these things. Ooh, a green one! Oh, tell me those are shotgun shells on the bar table over there. Okay, so red eye with lashes. Green eye, no lashes. Maybe that's an important thing. Excuse me. Oh, it's a first aid box. No, hang on. What? Bandage with blood? I have a ton of those. They're called gauze. Don't you sneaky your way over, little spider dude. No, not use it. Examine. Book with a red cover. We're just so intelligent. Let's open this thing, see what's what. Huh? It's a book, with a red cover. Nothing is printed on any of its pages. Is there a special way to see it? Oh! Wait a tick! What if we use it on... Maybe it only goes with the red lamp. Okay. Now, take... Ah, bloody hell. Alright, I'll have to remember that that's here. There's shotgun shells on that table. Ah! They're all over the thing! Bloody hell. Oh, I can just step on him! I can't carry anything. I was so scared of walking into those guys. Wow! Nice butt! Okay. An orange oil lamp. I thought that was broken, actually. Go ahead and light that. Simple eye, two markings. Okie doke. Let's see. Some billiard balls. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It doesn't seem to be anything significant about the order, but... This is like one of those things where you're looking at the puzzle and, like, you see the puzzle, but you don't recognize that it's a puzzle, and then you look at something else that's completely mundane. Oh, jeez. Stop. Completely mundane. Nothing out of the ordinary. There's absolutely nothing about this stuff. And we just obsess over it, like, oh, what could it mean? The billiards are arranged in such position. Oh, it must mean something. And, like, obviously it does mean something, but there's not really anything we can do about that. Oh, not that way. Let's head back this way. Let's try using the book on the red light. Not necessary to use it. Wait a second. You don't think that the eyelashes are like a hint, do you? Because it's like, that one has three lashes, the orange one had two lashes, and the green one back there had didn't have any. It just had a lined eye. So maybe it's green, orange, red? Maybe? Let's have a look at the billiards again. Let's see. Green, orange, red. So, 6, 5, 3? Possibly. Let's try and remember that. 6, 5, 3. I'll try and bear that in mind, but I don't know what I'd even use it for. Because, like, we've... Yeah, that's been cleared. That way there was for a gallery, but that didn't even have a lock. Couldn't do anything about these. That requires the power room, and that door was locked. Huh. I have no idea. Well, that's troubling, but I'll have to come back here later again anyway. Saw that circle on the ground, it was a dark shadow, I was like, what's that? Thought it was moving. It wasn't. Anyway. Moving on. Let's just get back in here and save, and I will continue this in the next one. Very troubling, because I'm not sure what to do. Unless... I'm thinking maybe I can open... No, it said gallery, not control room. But maybe that one? Hang on. I'm going to test a theory here. We're going to push this episode forward a little longer, as usual in my episodes these days, but, oh, good lord. I'll have to tussle with that anyway, won't I? Ah! Success! Awesome! So this time I won't have a heart attack, and we'll go through here, which I believe is the right way. There's the bees in here. Right, it does lead to the room where we need it. Okay, so we're going to breeze past this door. Yeah, it's locked. Gallery. Right. That's what I thought. Now, I don't think this will work, but it's possible that the door in the underground hallway thing is actually unlocked by the key that I have. So let's give that a try. Plus, we get to hear this cool soundtrack here again. Oh, it's locked from the other side. Okay. Though I'm not sure how we'd actually get there. Oh, this is the Aqua Ring! Oh, that makes sense. Especially for why it'd fill with water. Duh. I thought it was like a literal ring. Anyway. Okay, so that led nowhere. What is on the wall back there? Anyway, thank you all for watching. This, of course, has been Let's Go the Wrong Way. Let's play Resident Evil 1 with me, XelionGraves. And I will catch you in the next one. Later. Go ahead and get my outro nice and done. I'll go ahead and meet y'all back next time in the save room where hopefully I will figure something out. And also this hat. I want this hat.